feel so good it should cost. Bought an alligator, I ain't talking Lacoste. Made me say,
Chris D'Elia returns. I can't believe it. We were just saying that. Cheers. Here, let's have a Jello shot to that. And this is what Chris would give to the kids, allegedly. A little Jello shot. Here. Here he is.
Oh, really, cheers, dude?
And then he'd come in a cup, make them drink it. So he's even worse than we thought he was. Here's the problem with Chris coming back. You know what the problem with these Jello shots are? Whoa. They mess up my whole mustache.
You got one on your beard.
Yeah. And that's it for her. She's not having any more. And she apologized, actually. They wrote a whole apology to you guys. Didn't you? Didn't you have something to say to them?
Well, they get
She's sorry. She'll never doubt me again. Will she?
We'll see.
So that's it for her today. And Chris D'Elia is back. And what is more sickening than him being back is the response. His fans are, you know, it's really disgusting. It's heartbreaking watching the fans. They love him so much. They just don't care. And Chris is doing what Callen's doing. He's not addressing the stuff that he was accused of, you know, and we'll go over that. He's apologizing for something else that he is and tricking everybody, tricking them into thinking, oh, wait a minute, he was canceled for being a sex addict and he's trying to get help. He's great. No. He was canceled for exposing himself to women, having underage affairs, and like he admits here today, cheating on his fiance, which should be looked at as the worst thing you could do out of those three. To me, it's worse than hitting on an underage girl. Cheating on your fiance that you have a kid with is worse than hitting on an underage girl in terms of evilness. At least the underage girl is hot. Democracy, the underage girl. Chris D'Elia returns. Let's watch the video, and then I'll give you a play-by-play.
Some people are saying they haven't seen this, and we're saving it for the show. So
great.
Wait till you guys see this.
You're going to fucking die. Now, remember, this was a man who was so cocky. I mean, he was hopping around like Jack and the Beans. Or
should
not,
we show a video of him before
Yeah,
this?
Let's show Chris D'Elia before he was canceled and disappeared. Canceled himself, really. You know, he was fired by his agency. He was replaced in an action movie by a titless cancer patient, woman, lesbian. That's true. But that was it. Being dropped by your agent isn't being canceled. It's, oh, a scumbag liar doesn't want to work with you anymore because his career is based on a lie. Here was Chris D'Elia before the cancellation. The coolest guy that you've ever fucking met. Look at this asshole. Crazy. This was Chris D'Elia. Let me remind you who we're dealing with. I'm Redbar. This. Look at him.
What'd I tell you, dude? What did I fucking tell you, man? It's different now. It's fucking different now,
I mean,
man.
This is
I
like
let
a,
everybody know it.
This is like a Nick Kroll character. Rich Dix. I mean, look at this guy. And he comes from a rich Hollywood producer dad. He's literally dressed like this. Look how he's acting. This is why we hated him. Listen to this.
Texted all my friends. It's fucking different. Dude, it is different. All right? I got the fucking banging podcast. I got the special that came out. It's different now. And I said, I told fucking Steve Trevino, I told a bunch of fucking comedians, I told Eric Griffin, when the shit pops, when the shit really pops, is when it's different. And I'm fucking dressing differently, man.
Nice audio,
I'm dressing
by
differently.
The way.
Yeah. I went out to get a fucking coffee today, and somebody said, oh my God, I'm sorry. I have to stop you. I love your podcast. I love your stand-up. And I thought, that's the final straw, dude. I'm getting my fucking Chicago Hope 90s
fucking
denim jacket.
Oh my God, he's not wearing a shirt.
And I'm not wearing a fucking shirt anymore.
Whoa.
And I'm putting on these glasses that are like tint blue-green kind of, and I have a chain on because I'm DMX, and it's fucking different, dude. And I've said it's different.
He's not kidding. He was never kidding. You know, this is why we started hating him back in 2012. He couldn't not have his shirt off. And he would post these Instagram posts with his shirt off, cuddling with his dogs. And the caption would be, "Aren't my dogs adorable?" No, you wanted to show people you without a shirt on. That's what I accused you of. He's going to admit that all of that was true today in his apology video for being accused of being a pedophile, that he's going to rewrite history and apologize for something else and confuse his whole fan base that is too stupid to even pick up on it. But this was the Chris D'Elia from before. Well, he's got a change of character. He's back in his new clip after disappearing for a full year after being accused of. Jules, go down the list of what he was actually accused of.
He was accused of messaging underage girls.
Messaging underage girls.
He was accused of creepily hitting on about 100 different girls.
Creepily hitting on 100 different girls.
That all came out about how much of a creep he was on Twitter. He was accused of taking two girls up to his hotel room and then taking his dick out when they didn't want him to.
Exposing himself like Louis.
And trying to get him drunk. He was accused of calling a hotel worker up to his room.
Wow.
And when she knocked on the door, he opened it completely naked.
Naked. Exposing himself to the hotel maid.
And cheating on his wife.
And cheating on his wife.
And I'm sure there's more that I forget.
So he's going to try to claim that he was just a sex addict and didn't know any better at the age of 40. Now, the problem here is everybody has welcomed him back. Everybody. We got a real problem with remembering why things happened in the first place. Let's watch his bullshit apology and trickery and scheme. Here you go.
Hi, everyone. I know that it's been a really long time since you've heard from me, and when the news broke, I put out a statement.
Have you been taking quarantine seriously? Have you? Taking quarantine literally, I see. Look, white man. Holy, he does not look healthy, and this is not how you sit when you so have no dents. If you ever tuned into this show and I was sitting like this, you have my permission to either understand that it's a damn joke or kill me. Look at him. And he is dying his hair. His beard is gray and white and his hair is jet black. You know, I can't believe, by the way, if you're so sorry, you don't have any business working out and dyeing your hair while you've been canceled. If you really apologize. I don't want you like, oh, I'm canceled. Yeah, my sincerest apologies as you fucking lift weights. You should be coming back scrawny with gray hair. You shouldn't have been working out to look hot while you're canceled for your sex stuff, okay? So I don't understand why your hair has been dyed. That is a giant red flag. You're still trying to pick up chicks, aren't you? You know, the only reason a guy would dye his hair is to be more desirable to a woman, right? What would be the point?
So people are saying it looks like he got plugs, too. Wasn't his hair thin?
Oh, yeah, your hair was...
More?
So you're still into this, so that voids what this apology is going to come, because you're still into trying to... You have a fiance. You have a kid. You don't need to attract the opposite sex anymore. So gussying up to this level shows that you still are on that prowl. If Dr. Jordan Peterson told you that, you'd give him a standing ovation.
Statement that said everything I've done has been legal and consensual, and that's true.
Look at this.
And I wanted that statement to speak for itself. And I wanted to talk immediately. I wanted to post online. I wanted to do my podcast, business as
usual.
Then
why didn't you?
I thought... That might not be the best thing. What might
by
be the best?
By the way, he's in an all-wood room, unfinished, not even sanded. You know, you go the wrong way, you're going to get a splinter. And it does look like the inside of a pine box coffin. How symbolic, huh? You broadcasting from inside of your coffin? Sit up. Sit up. I sit like this, but I'm in terrible pain. And Jewish. There's no reason you need to be sitting like this unless you've done something to them kids.
Thing if I it would be if I just take this time to be with my family, try and take a long, hard look at myself, and
so
just
pathetic.
And do that. And
look at these faces he's making. These actor.
It was a lot. It was hard.
By the way, when anyone's making you're physically doing all, like, people don't make faces like this when they talk unless they're an actor or me trying to play to the camera. You don't make, that's why these actors get hired, because they're so expressive, right? But they're not naturally, you're doing this, your face. So when anyone's doing that, they're acting. That's a dead giveaway when someone's lying, when they're
looking down. It takes a lot of work.
Looking down to think, pausing. This is called acting, and he was an actor, an action actor.
I do know how it looks, with all the stuff that's been said and the emails.
Beat red compared to him. I let everyone know I was camping in the desert. This is not alcoholism. This is a sick tan.
You look great.
This is a pale guy. I look great, but I'm looking at the monitor. I look like I'm about to pop like a thermometer top.
No, you don't look red. You just look nicely tan.
Oh,
at
good.
Least on my screen.
Well, he is so pab looking at the. It's crazy.
Oh wow, on yours, you
yeah.
Look
at that. Psycho.
Been put out there, and what the media has been trying to say, and I know it looks bad, and it doesn't.
Why did you disappear for a year? You know, it's that has to be answered to.
I wanted to take some time with my family.
You took it. Could have taken a month. And your wife is like some stripper nonsense family. That's not real family. That's you accidentally pumped up some hookah and had a kid, and now it's got to be the family or else. You know? And you've cheated on her, which she's going to admit. Which was my big thesis on you, that you're a cheat, a lying, dirty cheat. Cheating and lying are the same thing. I shouldn't have to explain this again. You cheat on your wife. You've lied to society, reality, the world, to her, to your family, to your son. It's the biggest lie you could tell is to cheat. It's the biggest lie there is. Being a liar of that level is bad, too. Some people don't understand. They go, so what? He's a liar. We all... No, we don't. It's the worst thing you could do.
Show the full scope of what happened. I stand by the fact that all my relationships have been consensual and legal, and that's just it.
Yeah, no doubt. What are you going to say? Well, they've been pretty illegal. Any person would deny that at all costs. You're never going to get a guy like accused of underage things and go, yes, I like them young. Why would you? You're going to just say they were consensual. But, I mean, you know, so many people came out and said they weren't. Why would you go in hiding over consensual relationships?
That's the truth.
Oh.
I threw this kind of time away. I've seeked out a lot of kind of... you know, medical advice, therapy, and stuff like that.
You've seeked out medical advice? Doink. Oh, doink. Can I hit you with that thing on the knee? You know, what kind of medical advice did you seek? Why would you seek medical advice for these consensual relationships that you had? You know, it's pretty weird. Medical advice.
A lot of kind of, you know, medical advice, therapy, and stuff like that. That doesn't matter here nor there, but what I have come to understand is this was always about sex to me.
Whoa.
My life was, I mean, sex, it controlled my life.
Thank you, late. Can I get an apology then? Thank you all. This was my hatred of you. In 2012, I wrote a beautiful song called The Untitled BuzzFeed Project. Let's see if we could find that. And each verse focused on a different problem. And it was a rap song. It's really cool. It's been copied. Untitled BuzzFeed Project by Here SoundCloud. Mike David, Untitled. Oh, there's Genius lyrics about it. Look at this.
Oh, my God.
I'm on Genius. The Untitled BuzzFeed Project on Genius. Look at this. And let's go to this last verse about Chris D'Elia. Stop it. Look at this. Verse 3. Stop it with the pictures of your face. It's insane, obnoxious, and it's everything you ain't. I've been saying, and if you take a selfie every day, you're in pain. And if you are a guy, you're fucking gay. For instance, once there was this show on NBC. It stinked, but that's besides the thing. This guy upon the screen, okay, we'll call him Chris. He had his eye on other things. And I don't know why, but I follow him, and what I found is going to make you scream. Oh, look at this. I just went to look at his pics. Little bitch fucking blocked me. What a fucking cock tease. It's not going to stop me. Watch me. Chris D'Elia, stop taking topless photos with your dog. They're not about your dog. Your fucking shirt is off. What a fraud. Trying to make like it's all about a dog. What a sexy boy. Gotta get those likes. You're an embarrassment to the whole mankind. Die! What a gay guy.
Poetic.
2012.
Turns out that he was posting all of those because he's a sex addict, you said.
I think people want to hear the song now. They're probably dying. Is there a music video for this?
Oh, my God.
Yeah. You like nice. Almost fucking anything. And I make
fun of fucking everything. Of everything. I think what I'm trying to
we'll
say
take a drink.
Like,
listen.
Enough. We fucking get it.
Stop.
We already heard
enough.
You. Fucking cram it, lady.
Shut up. Shut up.
Enough. Stop it with the articles for clicks. It's all shit. It's like my fucking father with the chips. It's false. It's been bothering
cheers,
a
everybody.
Lot of fucking kids. I lost it. A holler from the bottom of my ribs. Shut up, bitch. I don't give a fuck about a Tony or who might be responsible for what they did to Sony.
Sony.
I call you phony, but none of you even know me. And these Ariana Grande pics are giving me a bony. So long, homie. Oh. In the way, go phony. Your picture's now an equal sign. Tell Takai to blow me. Megan, baby, I think you could use a trainer.
Trainer.
Lisa Lampanelli with a bit of jealous anger. We need a tanker. Cause Mary Lambert's very overweight, dear God. Even if she wanted to, she couldn't change. Ryan Lewis, where will your mind die of fucking AIDS? That's not a joke, you'll one day be inside a fucking grave. Yay!
Why you gotta be so gay?
She really does have AIDS.
Enough! We
this song's bad!
We already heard
enough.
You! Fucking cram it, lady!
Shut up, shut up!
Enough! Lena Dunham fucked her little sister. It's official. She's an animal and none of us will miss her. Not just a kisser, but this bitch is a disastrous example of what actually can happen to a million fucking fat women. Keep on having sandwiches. Keep on telling fat bitches and nothing bad is happening. Yeah, that's it. How convenient. It's the media's fault. It's not from needing
wow.
It all. We weren't meant to be small. False. Pig, you're arguing with science. Rationalizing why you can't go on a simple fucking diet. You haven't tried it, liar. Meanwhile, people are dying, liar. Meat tough, put up in a sliders, liar. Belly full of guilt in a pie insider.
Die!
You sack of potatoes. Why you gotta be so fat?
Enough! We fucking get it.
Stop. Stop.
We already heard
enough.
You.
Enough!
Fucking
here's the Chris D'Elia part.
Up.
Come
shut
on.
Up.
Enough! Stop it with the pictures of your face. It's insane, obnoxious, and it's everything you ain't. I've been saying it. If you take a selfie every day, you're in pain. And if you are a guy, you're fucking gay. For instance, once there was a show on NBC. It stinked, but that's besides the thing. This guy upon the screen, let's think. Okay, we'll call him Chris. He had his eye on other things.
Other things.
I don't know why, but I follow him. And what I found's gonna make you scream.
Scream.
Oh, look at this. I just went to look at his pics.
What a fucking cocktail.
He's not gonna stop me. Watch me. Chris D'Elia. Stop taking topless photos with your dog. They're not about your dog. Your fucking shirt is off. What a fraud. Trying to make like it's all about a dog. What a sexy boy. Gotta get those likes and embarrassment to the homie.
Sing it.
Die.
What a gay guy. Why
you gotta be a little bitch?
He really blocked me.
Enough!
We fucking get it.
Thank you.
We already
thank
heard
you.
Enough! Fucking
Die.
Damn it, lady!
Shut up. Shut up.
Enough!
Wow. And cut to now. I deserve an apology. Let's go to Chris D'Elia's
like
video.
9 years ago.
Nine, really?
I mean, 2012.
And let's go back to Chris D'Elia's apology. Let's see what he actually is according to him.
It was the focus. It was my focus.
Sex.
All the time. And I had a problem. And I do have a problem. It's not like you know, months down the line, you just kind of, everything's better. I need to do work on that. When I first started doing stand-up and I started getting a little bit of notoriety in my early 30s, you know, having sex got a lot easier is the, you know.
Okay, that's fine.
For lack of better words.
That's all fine, by the way.
And I felt lucky. I felt like, oh, wow, I don't need to work as hard, you know. I can just do a show and then have sex or roll into a city.
You know, I really want you to focus on this actory little monologue, sing-songy type of speech. I mean, it's bullshit. You don't
this
talk
came
like
from
that.
From a writer's room.
I just thought it would be easy. I expected it. Shut the fuck up! You producer's boy, lying sack of sex. Listen to what he's going to say next.
And look at my inbox and then just start writing. And I did, man. I wrote.
Listen to this.
I mean, I know you've seen some of the messages online. I mean, there's way more than that.
Whoa.
I would
really?
Get 50, at least 50 messages after a show each city a night. And I would reply to all
every
of-
night after the show, 50 to 100 girls he'd talk to. Okay. That was last year. You're not reformed. That's fucking repulsive. Imagine, you know, we've all seen that show where a guy's trying to like juggle two dates at one restaurant. Uh-oh. Imagine 100. It's not possible. I want to create a sketch where I'm Chris D'Elia at a restaurant, but I go to every table at this giant, like,
17.
P.F. Chang's. It's P.F. Chang's, and I'm literally on a date with every person in the building from every floor, and I'm going, now that's a sketch, Amy Schumer. So, yeah, that, okay, is enough for me to hate you for life. These people, they go, he's being so vulnerable. Oh, that must mean he's great. Stop it.
That means they would all do the same thing.
So does that mean you would do the same thing? Juggle 100 girls a night? You know how sick that is? Listen, I want to fuck after a show, whether it's Jules or someone else. And there's nothing wrong with fucking chicks. There is something wrong with trying to fuck 100 of them in a night. That's psychotic. You should, you know, even when I was fucking these skanks out on tour, you'd be nice to them. That's why you don't have any stories about me being terrible. I fucked millions of these bitches. By millions, I mean about 40, you know, throughout my time. And, but you just focus on one or two, not 100 in your 40s.
And every single person.
While you have a wife and a kid. And?
I mean, all of the stories were like, he was a complete creep and just messaged me and said, want to suck my dick? Want to suck my friend's dick? It's like they're coming out and telling these stories about you
because
they had a bad experience.
Because it was a bad experience. It wasn't, oh, he had sex with me after show. What a creep. It's, he just messaged me. Want to suck my dick, bitch? Want to suck my dick? You know, this is me after a show.
If he was sweet to you, they would have no
problem.
This
is me after a show picking up a girl. Rock-a-bye, girl. Let's go have sex. You are my lover. Mm. I was so nice. This is him. Yeah, you want to fuck me? Next. You want to fuck me? Next. Yeah, me and Brendan Schaub are friends. Next. Yeah, Chris D'Elia. I mean, that's revolting. They're going to write about that.
Them. And I thought in my mind that being straight up with these women was the right thing to do. I'd say, hey, come to my hotel room and let's have sex. Let's make out. Let's do this. Let's do that. That was what I thought was right.
Again, he wasn't 26. 40 years old. 38 years old. You know? It's older than me. And I'll tell you this. There's a big difference between your 20s, 20 through 30. You're allowed to be a maniac, I'd say. After 35, this stuff shouldn't even be something you're into. It shouldn't be something you're after.
Grow up and get a boyfriend.
You got to grow up and get a boyfriend. And he had a boyfriend. He had a fiance and a kid. And he's out doing this. And it's not because, listen, everybody, you do a show, you're single, you want to get laid afterwards. It's a big part of why everyone does this. That's fun. There's nothing wrong with sex. Sex is fun. It's the sickness. It's the abuse. It's the he doesn't care. It's how he treats them. It's how every one of them was to feed his sickness. Freddy Krueger collecting souls. And they picked up on this. They saw how they were treated. They weren't a partner in this fun. They were another notch on Chris's disgusting condom belt. And he didn't use condoms. He injected them. And believe me, the way he fucks them. You've seen these people. I've seen these people. I've been in these ninesomes. You see one guy?
Ew.
Jackhammering. You're
going.
Ninesomes. It's a joke. But you see how some people do treat women and they get animalistic with them. And it's not even with the women. It's about them. And it's sick. It's the same thing as like looking at your muscle while you're fucking a chick in the mirror. It's a sick fucking way. It's disgusting.
They turn into like a completely different person.
Girls will tell you, go sit down and talk to a girl. Some guys turn into like vulturous monsters.
You'll be like talking to someone the whole night or even like your friend and you like know this person so well. And then the second something sexual starts to happen, it's like their face goes blank.
Yeah.
Their eyes go like Terminator-y and they're just like...
I crave. And it's all like about so just coming. And they just, it's a race to coming. It has nothing to do with having any fun. It's a crazy sickness. Sorry, I just had to drink some spit. Let's hear more. This gets really perverse.
I realized through all of this that doing that is just treating sex like it's casual and being flippant with people.
You see how he's apologizing for this? And this is like, hey, man, it's all understandable. We all love... That's not the problem. The problem was... You want to list that list again? Because people really lose track. It was the underage girls. It was the flashing. It was the San Fernando flasher type behavior. You called up a hotel maid when she answered the door. You went, ta-da! See anything
and
like?
Even besides all that stuff, hundreds of people all came out on the same day to say that you were a creep to them and that you disgust them. So you were embarrassed out of town.
It's not like they all just hooked up with you and isn't he a sleaze because he hooks up. I mean, this is human beings. This is what we're meant to do. That's why it feels good. No one's mad at you because you had sex. They're mad at you because you're a creep, sick, evil creep.
And that's not the guy I want to be. It's not okay, and I'm sorry for that.
It is okay if that's all it was.
It makes me feel shameful, and it makes me feel bad.
Having sex with a fan after every show you've done is okay. I want to make that perfectly clear. That's okay. Being a creep, doing it to underage girls, the exposing, the flashing, the sickness, that's what's not okay. If I didn't think that was okay, how could I listen to Aerosmith? You know, I always go back to Aerosmith. You don't think Aerosmith, this is the whole reason the guitar was invented was for this fucking. Fucking is fine.
But Aerosmith actually had style.
Yeah.
And they could get girls before they were famous.
If Steven Tyler acted like you, he'd be finished.
But Chris probably got no girls before he got fame because look at him. And so he doesn't know how to talk to them.
Yeah.
He doesn't know how to romance
anyone. Wait, what do you mean look at him? A lot of girls think he's a stud. You don't think he's hot?
I do not believe that.
You wouldn't suck
really
his long, John. Chris, why don't you come over and fuck my wife? Let's see how it goes. He starts fucking her, and then I cut his dick with my axe. And then he
it sticks into my leg, but yeah. It's worth it.
Oh, man. Look at, and you're looking up. There's no one there. There's no one up there.
He's 40.
You're
like,
40.
You really...
This is 40, the movie.
Have to go for girls that are that young.
And you were Mr. Saturday Night. I mean, you were the cockiest guy in the room.
And this is what I always say. If he was like, people like to bust people for being not who they say they are. And Chris was this, he's the coolest guy. People are flocking to him.
Yeah.
He's famous. He's Mr. Money. He has no dents. And then all these girls come out and say, he's disgusting. How is he supposed to come back from that?
Exactly. What type of career do you have after this? Well, let's play the video. And let's hope, is there going to be a new Chris? Mike owns an axe, LOL. Yeah, where were you here during the bee camping story? Yes, I own an axe and a hatchet and starter fluid. A lot of stuff.
You know, people talk a lot about the power dynamic and about, why should someone who is a fan of yours have to worry about if you want to sleep with them or not? And I don't know where I fall on that, you know? I sometimes think, especially in my early 30s, I would be like, well, the girl has the power because that's, you know, they I want to have sex with them, and if they want to have sex with me, then great.
Yes, that's fine.
But what
I don't agree with that. I think all the stuff that guys do where they're like, I didn't know that I had the power over her. It's like if you're 30 and you're in a situation with a girl, you should know what's going on. It's like, I don't buy
Oh, yeah, of
all
course.
This.
Yeah, you should know what's going on. But
I
mean,
I was doing this. I didn't know that.
I still think it's okay after a show. Hey, you to the room. Let's go. I still think that's fine. I don't find a problem with that as long as everyone's overage. It's how you treat them that's the problem. You're nice to them. What do they want? Sex too. It's fun. There's nothing wrong with that. I think it's he's a creep. They saw it in his eyes. Well, because it wasn't about them. It was about him.
But it's like this guy who can tell it like it is about every single thing on earth. Oh, I didn't know what was going on. It's like, yes, you did.
Oh, yeah, I know. Yeah, you're 40 years old. Again, you weren't 22. You know what's going on. And again, it's not even about that. It's not that you had sex with a 29-year-old girl after a show. No one would care.
I can say is the familiarity, I would use the familiarity that I had with these women to have sex. I was like, oh, they already used me. They already know me. I didn't have to.
Not a problem. I don't
do
even
the extra
care
work.
About that.
And I was talking to one of my friends who...
Brendan Callen?
I was talking to one of my friends about this and about the power dynamic and about the familiarity and not having to use that. And I said, why is that behavior not okay? Why is it not okay to sleep with somebody if it's consensual and they want to sleep with you? And he said, it's okay... Well, it is okay. It's okay until it's not.
It's okay if you're nice and not a creep. It's okay if you're not doing it to girls when you're 40. An 18-year-old girl is too young. It just is, right? That's creepy. The flashing. It's about the flashing and the underage. Nobody cares.
And it's
about being creepy. It's about you being weird and obsessive and having an addiction and doing it behind everyone's backs and the lying. It's about they thought you were one way and it turns out you had a secret life of sin. That's what it's about. It's not about the sex. We all monkey around. It's about the lying. The being bad. It's about you weren't who you said you were. You were living a secret life. That's what everybody cancels everyone for, The Secret Life.
And it's like you said, you meet a girl after the show. You're like, ooh, 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 this is fun. We're flirting. We met each other. Let's go fuck, blah, blah, blah. You're aware of how the girl's feeling. You can read her body language and you know what she's putting off to you. And he obviously just
you would force it. It's almost you would force them because maybe these 18-year-old girls didn't want to fuck, but you would go, let's fuck, baby. And they'd be like, okay. Huh? But I mean, why wouldn't you want to? I don't know. I mean, I feel like they'd want to fuck, but it's not about that. It's about afterwards. They went, ooh, he's sick. This wasn't a fucking. This was like that movie. What was that movie with that guy? By M. Night Shyamalan. He did that movie with that freak. The latest one. Sliver. No, what's his name? Shelter.
Glass.
Split. He was acting like Split from M. Night Shyamalan. Split. That's not good. So don't act like Split and then you won't get canceled.
And that was when, you know.
Wait till you hear this, though.
A lot of it clicked for me. It was something that just became life-controlling. I mean, I would think about it all the time. I would go and I would do my show, and I, you know, like I just said earlier, and I just, it was too much, and it became a lifestyle that I didn't know how to stop.
Oh. You weren't in control of your sex addiction.
Oh. So everything we said about you is true.
Oh. So you're crazy. Cool. Thought you had it all together. You were telling it like it is on the Netflix stage.
I didn't think I had a problem. I thought that this was how it was. I thought that guys in my position were lucky enough and fortunate enough. And it just, it was going out of control.
Imagine if I made a video like this. I mean, even if I raped and killed somebody, I'd make a video dressed as the Jew character coming back. Sorry for the raping, me pretty. That's what I would do. You'll never see me like this, ever. I'd rather die.
And I never stopped it. I cheated on most of the girls that I've been with.
Cheated on most of the girls that I've been with. I mean,
oh, really, dude?
Case closed. That should be as bad as it gets. I mean, really? Why is that not looked at as disgusting to people? Why is that so common? Because you hear about it all the time. That's not common. Wake up. You shouldn't cheat on anyone unless the girl's really hot. It was one time, you know, which I haven't done, but I probably would. It's a sickness. I mean, the lying, the cheating, the covering up, the planning, the plotting. That's not.
I mean,
oh,
to cheat
thinking,
on your
I mean,
wife
listen,
that you're going to have a baby with.
But even still, I could
fiance.
Go as far to say, listen, if you're famous, you have a wife and you have a kid and you're out, you're drunk and there's girls grabbing all over you. I could see how someone could slip, but to plot and plan and this is your daily activity, that's completely different.
He just said himself that it consumed his
consumed
life.
Consumed him. Banging. Sex addicts are disgusting.
It Listen was to this. Going out of control.
Listen.
And I never stopped it. I cheated on most of the girls that I've been with. I cheated on my fiance now.
Oh, he's a great guy. I didn't even know that. I assumed it as a joke. So Santino must be cheating on his wife then, too. I mean, I accused you of cheating on your wife all the time. And you just admitted it. You cheat on your fiance that you have now? That's worse than what they said you did in the articles. That's worse than a flashing. The flashing, if you're a single guy and you're flashing, that's fun. That's funny. To cheat on your wife that you have a kid with? You're a monster. You're a monster.
And this is my dream girl. This is the girl that I want to be with for the rest of my life.
Wow.
And even that wouldn't stop what I was doing. And I was headed for I was headed for this. And this needed to happen because...
Oh, yeah. It's all good. It's all positive.
I wouldn't have stopped cheating. I wouldn't have stopped.
You wouldn't have stopped cheating. And we're supposed to go, oh, everyone makes mistakes like this where they can't stop cheating. No! You're 40 years old. You're up on stage making millions telling us how to live. You got a kid. Get it together. There's no excuse. And his fans are eating it up. They love it.
There's a girl in the chat right now that says Chris messaged her, and this whole thing is what brought her to Redbar.
Wow, look at that.
She's sending me her screenshots.
They're everywhere. They're everywhere, and we got those screenshots. And this is a lie, too. What do you think? It's out of his system? You crave. You're a greedy, pleasure-craving, nonsense person. That's why we made fun of you in 2012. And here you are, admitting to it all. Again, you do the stuff he did. What else? What won't he do? Oh, I'm so, he's so vulnerable. Oh, melts my heart. He's such a great guy. Are you out of your mind? Did you not have a family? Did you not have a real father or a mother to teach you this shit?
Using sex.
Uh-oh. He's loading. What's going on here? We haven't had a problem like this in years. Uh-oh. We've got a loading problem. Is it going to be like Andrew Schultz comes out and goes, hey, everybody, it's me, Chris. I'm not going to fall for that again. Right?
That's weird.
I know. What's going on here?
I guess.
Let's restart. Where were we? Six minutes.
Hi, everyone.
Yeah. Okay. Hi, everyone. A regular Mr. Rogers.
I thought that guys in my position were lucky enough and fortunate enough. And it just, it was going out of control. And I never stopped it. I cheated on most of the girls that I've been with. I cheated on my fiance now. And this is my dream girl. This is the girl that I want to be with for the rest of my life. And even that wouldn't stop.
Again, before the apology was given, he sat in the mirror and he dyed his hair. He went to the salon and had that done. You got to imagine the scene of the man dyeing his hair to really understand why I picked it. Imagine the time, the mirror, the looking, the futzing. It's unattractive.
I was doing. And I was headed for a... I was headed for... You know what I was headed for? I was headed for this.
Redbar?
And this needed to happen because I wouldn't have stopped cheating. I wouldn't have stopped using sex. I wouldn't have stopped.
Using sex.
Wow. So I have a chance here to...
You wouldn't have stopped. You would have kept plowing through him, huh?
His therapist is like, just call it using sex. It's a drug to you.
Look at him looking down. Oh, what's the problem, sir? Do you need some food? Look at you. You look like first bitten, just bitten. I mean, you really look like a fucking vamp. You might be a vampire with all this sex. I've seen True Blood.
To really, you know, and I have been doing the work and being somebody who is a role model for my son.
What work have you been doing? The hair dyeing and the pumping iron? That's sex work. Look at this face he's making. And they call me chipwrecked. Look at that. You could be my Theodore in my Alvin and the Chipmunks real life reanimation movie. Me, you, and who else? We could get Tim Dillon to play Simon. I'll be Alvin. You could be Theodore. We'll get Tim Dillon to play Simon. All right? We'll do Alvin and the Chipmunks, and we'll all rape someone.
And I want to do that, and I can't stress that enough, you know? I can't...
Tears time.
Go
Here's
back,
the tears.
And I can't fix...
Get me that crybaby. Boom, 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 boom. Crybaby. I love that song. It's from the 50s. They knew. Jim Carrey's the fire marshal. I don't know. Who could play that guy? What was that dad's name in Alvin and the Chipmunks? What was he doing with those fucking rodents? Alvin! Yeah, he's a chipmunk, man. Calm down. What did you think was going to happen when you adopted three chipmunks? Sick fuck. You know? He's always going on a date, too. Who could play that? Michael Fishman could play the dad. He's perfect for it. We'll have to dye his hair jet black. Give me that crybaby song.
I sent it.
Oh, you sent it over.
Oh, okay.
No, that's fine. Play it here. Because I want to get you up crybaby.
I thought you wanted karaoke.
Oh, we got karaoke. Okay. Here we go.
Is this it?
Yeah.
Well, I don't know.
Crybaby and stuff. Let's see.
Let's see what happens. I'll serenade him. Chris, it's gonna be okay.
I don't see any words here, but
Chris, just know that I will take care of you in every sense of the way. Ba ba boo. Yes, I know that your face misses getting those lips kissed. But you can't just keep going through kid after kid after kid. Yeah. Chris, you can't do this. Chris, yeah. You can't do this too. If you want to kiss someone, kiss me. Yeah, I can take you. Chris D'Elia, everybody, and the Redbar Singers. There, like I'm Kathy Griffin. Good night, Chris. Back to your holy rest. Wah, 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 wah. Wah, 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 wah. He is sad. I am ecstatic. And this really fucking rules. I said this rules. Yeah. I said this rules. Yeah. Crybaby Chris.
Thank you. Crybaby Chris. I don't think that's the same song.
I know. There's a lot of songs called Crybaby.
All right, let's listen to the rest of his tier. And again, this is being accepted by millions of people as if he's better than me.
Now, I think despite all of the people who are accepting him back freely,
yeah,
and despite all of his crimes, the most interesting thing is going to be how he continues his career.
Yeah,
like,
I can't
just
wait.
Don't see how he can reconcile this person he's being right
how
now.
How are you going to have no dents? How are you gonna? This is, by the way, official Chris D'Elia merch that I purchased. He put out this sweater during Christmas. No dents and money bags Christmas sweater. People go, Mike, why didn't you wear this today? I tried it on. Too tight.
I looked really bad in it. And
not
I couldn't
bad.
Do 8 hours in this. This is a sweater, no dents, meaning.
Yeah, you think? I don't give a fuck. I got no dents.
Like a car, like he can plow through it all and nothing happens to him?
Hmm.
I see. Well, explain that to me then. Okay. All right. No dents. I got the mask. I got it all.
I know your story. Let's see how he explains the rest of this.
Part of me, that hole in me that was...
Money bags! Someone says, yes, money bags. What happened?
He has a hole in him.
He has a hole in him. Can you believe he put money bags on a shirt?
Trying to be filled with that, you know, the loneliness on the road or the fear that I felt or the insecurity that I would try to chase and just conquer with this.
Oh, that's cool.
With sex. And it was...
Yeah, the sweatshirt was too tight. Just like the pussies of the girls he was trying to fuck. Sorry, Chris. Didn't it feel good, though, to come? Oh, the feeling at the end. Stupid.
It was out of control. So I have a chance here to apologize to the people.
I want to tell you what some guy in the UK says in his head. He goes,
looks pretty dented as he goes in on a 20-minute apology, mate.
That's what someone said from the UK.
Ashley Butterfield.
Yeah, so I know your comments are all, you're the best. Oh, we love what you do to the women. Not around here, Chris. There's still a handful of people who think you're sick.
Who got caught up in that shit. And
look at this.
You know, the lies.
The lies.
That I would tell my fiance, my friends.
The lies that you would tell your fiance and your friends. Oh, he's great. I can't wait to watch his next installment of a lie.
That's what I mean about all these comments.
Yeah.
They're like, yes, I'm so glad to have you back. Life rips. This is amazing. We missed you. But it's like, even if you did really want him to come back, don't you see that this isn't the Chris D'Elia that you miss?
Yeah, like they don't care. I mean, I'm telling you, these people are so insane.
Even if you love him so much, shouldn't the comments be like, well, man, that's crazy.
Well,
I hope
you
you
weren't the guy
soon.
You said you were. I guess we got to find a guy who is. Isn't that what you should want? Or do you want him to just do the act again? And you can pretend he's this badass slayer. Remember, I will Denny's Grand Slam you. You've been Denny's grand slammed, he would say to his detractors.
You can't grand slam anyone.
Can't grand
after
slam
this.
Anyone.
Never
Maybe
again.
A waitress. You could go to Denny's, try to have sex with a 65-year-old waitress now.
Shit. And, you know, the lies that I would tell my fiance,
cool.
my friends.
I love lies.
And I'm sorry.
Oh.
You know, I think that being a comedian, it's funny, the stuff that you tell yourself to make it okay, you know.
Shut up!
Like the cheating and the sex every night or whatever. You know, well, any guy would do this, which is not true. Or
he's saying that because he wants people in the comments to go, you're right, man.
You're
any
right,
guy
dude.
Would
no,
do
any
that
guy
in
would...
your position.
Yeah. Sorry, Chris. Let's hear the rest of this. It's truly pathetic. I can't wait to watch. I hope he comes back and starts doing his podcast because it's going to be full of dents. It's going to be full of holes. How does this cocky slayer of women come back and do that show under the new circumstances? Are you going to be just like a touching guy now? Is everything going to be like a serious lesson now?
You're
like, what's
like
it going to be?
Jordan Peterson after the brain damage type guy?
What's going to happen? Who's the new you? Or does it not even
matter?
It's
very exciting.
It probably doesn't even matter. They'll just go back to their same old spiel. I mean, Brian Callen's trying to do that. Brian Callen's the same old weasel he was before the cancellation. Just now his eyes are crazier looking.
Or whatever it is. And I just
look at this.
I don't know.
He's got him though. Hook, line, and sinker. They believe it. They believe what, by the way?
It was too much, and I made too many excuses.
See, people, it's like they like Chris D'Elia because they're stupid enough to just fall for an actor to begin with. You know, they just see an actor. It's like no different than the people who are like obsessed with Jennifer Aniston. For what? Just because she's famous and an actor? You know, they're just obsessed with him. They don't care. And this is the same acting that they loved from him in the show, You. They just want to see him act and they want to go crazy and scream. Like psycho fans that we see in documentaries screaming on the sidelines while a bus with Britney Spears drives in. What are you doing? We'll never understand. And now you see him in the comments. There they are. They love him. Well, what do you love him for? Can you even articulate what you love about this?
And I can't do it anymore. And I haven't been. And I've been trying. I've been on this path of recovery now for
recovery.
A bunch of months.
So you're fine.
I'm doing well. And
no, you're not.
You know, it's the hardest. It's the hardest thing ever to have to look at yourself and realize that that's what it is, and that's what you've done, and that's who you are. And so that's that.
Oh,
but thanks for listening. And
you're welcome.
I appreciate you all. Thanks.
Why didn't you fade to black? Stupid! You just missed a very funny opportunity. So yeah, look at this: 90,000 likes. Only 4.9 thousand dislikes.
This was the most unexpected thing to see today. Very excited to also have this epiphany in 10 years. Oh, that sounds like a joke. Joey Diaz just said about a week or two ago, he told him to quit hiding. See? I'm making an algorithm to track Chris D'Elia's eyebrow move. Okay, that's pretty cool. I have that same shirt. I can't take him seriously while he's wearing a medium shirt. Okay, that's not so bad. These are different than they were yesterday.
Yeah, we saw this like a couple hours after it was posted. Yeah.
I'm still here for the silly goose time and nothing else. Hard to believe with such maturity and honesty that this is, in fact, the youngest man who have ever... I mean, they really love him.
But
welcome back, Chris.
When I first looked this up on Twitter,
yeah,
it was tons of people being like, yeah, he's back, my babies. But now I'm looking it up and there's more people against him.
Good.
I'm putting them in the note if you
want. Good. Because that, you know, I was really most disturbed by the people.